Pennsylvania's Laurel Highlands, a haven of sparkling waterways, rolling countryside, natural wonders, and pristine mountains. Pennsylvania's Laurel Highlands, a place of wonder in any season. More information at laurelhighlands.org.
Turn it on with Green Power. Thinking about building a deck or other wooden structure? You'll want to see this story.
Anything you use in the household process, we use grocery bags, milk jugs, soda bottles. We receive all the plastic from the Cambria County Solid Waste Authority, plus the local people, they would bring their plastic to our facility.
It's a marriage made in heaven, so to speak. We bring them the plastic and they can manufacture it into something else that people in the local community can use.
These green ones are made out of the grocery bags, and the different color ones are made out of the milk jugs and mixed plastic. We've been pretty open to the people. Everyone has their own choices. So we let them pick the color. We have made all different kind of colors, blue and pink and yellow. And these are the grocery bags, margarine containers. Once the plastic comes in our facility, we put it on a conveyor. We grind them into the small pieces. Then we take it into the mixer and mix it with 30% of the sawdust and 70% plastic. Then we put it into extruder. Extruder has about 5 ovens, and they would melt it and mix it with the color and then give the shape people want. Whatever they like, they will make it. This is the retaining wall block. Some of the volunteers came up and they designed this block, which is about 15 pounds. Most of the retaining wall blocks, cinder blocks, weighs about 55 pounds. Even the small kids can build their own walls. The best part about the business I like is getting the community involved, helping the environment, and keeping the area clean.
In the grand scheme of things, for landfills and whatnot, the more plastics go in there, the worse off we are, because they're the one thing that really does not degrade, doesn't rot, doesn't rust, doesn't break down. And if it does, I like to think none of us are going to be here to see it. It just takes that long.
Originally, the idea when we started, we wanted to see what it takes to make the company self-sufficient. And what we have found is if we have a small recycling place between around 300,000 people population, it becomes a self-sufficient. People do like to recycle. Only reason they don't is because of the transportation cost. That is the reason we like to see small centers like this are across the state. So all the plastic coming in is produced, converted into the product, and going back into the public. And we have realized that 300,000 people makes the perfect close the loop kind. It closes the complete loop, the plastic coming in and going out. This is the future, and I think we need to conserve the environment. And this is the one of the outlay where we are making some dent. We are not changing totally, but we hope we are helping to change and changing people's attitude about throwing the plastic into the garbage.
People are looking for the opportunities. And from the calls that we field every single day at the office, people are calling with, how do I get rid of this? Or can I recycle this? You're finding a lot more awareness nowadays between us and the media, all the television stations with their Go Green push, and all the marketing that's out there. Well, I think awareness is definitely on the rise, and that's never a bad thing.
Have you used this product? Let us know at www.greenlifepenn.org.